So guys, next thing that we will going to discuss is the select system call. So select system calls allows the server machine to monitor multiple clients connected connections and check which client has sent the data to the process. So select system call is used to monitor multiple clients which are already connected with the server, and using select system call the server keeps monitoring the multiple clients connections and check that which client has sent data and which client needs a service. So you can understand it like this. Suppose there is a client C1, there is a client C2, and there is a client C3. All these clients are connected to the server, right? So all these clients, that is C1, C2, C3, are already connected with the server S. So at any point of time, the client C1 can send a data to the server S, a client C2 can send data to the server S, or a client C3 can send a data to the server S. So using select system call, the server S monitors the connections of the client C1, C2, and C3 at the same time. That is, in whatever order or in whatever sequence any of these clients sends a data to the server S will be in a position to identify that which client has sent a data and which client needs a service. Right? So select system call helps the server S to achieve simultaneous monitor of connected clients. In addition, suppose there is a client C4 which is not connected to the server S, but sends a new connection initiation request to the server S. So using select system call, the server S not only can monitor the existing connected clients, but it can also monitor the new connection initiation request that is sent by the new client to the server. Right? So select system call is actually used to monitor multiple file descriptors. So you can relate it to this example that just like in a class, the monitor, that is the class monitor, keeps an eye on all the students of the class at the same time. Using select system call, the server also keeps an eye on all the file descriptors of connected clients, as well as it also monitor the arrival of new connection initiation requests from new clients. And appropriately, server S can take an action. Select system call is a blocking system call. That is, the moment the server calls the select system call gets blocked. Right? So blocking system call means that when the select system call is executed, the code execution halts. For example, you may have written your own small programs in which you must have used the functions like scanf or getch. Right? And you must have experienced that the call to these functions actually halt the execution of a program. Similarly, the select system call also blocks the execution of a program. So such calls are called as blocking system call, and select system call is one such blocking system call. Select system call unblocks when either of the two things happen on the server side. That is, either a server receives the new connection request from new client, that is, when the new client C4 sends the new connection initiation request to the server S unblocks from the select system call. So this is the scenario 1. And the server S unblocks from the select system call when data request from existing connected client arrives. So this is the scenario with clients C1, C2, and C3, right? So the server unblocks from the select system call when either the event 1 happens or either the event 2 happens. So when select system call unblocks, server needs to check whether it's a new connection request or new data request on existing connection, right? So in the latter case, server needs to find which client has sent the data, right? Because the server can unblock from the select system call when either the client C2 has sent the data, or when the client C3 has sent the data. So when the server S unblocks from the select system call, it has to identify that it is unblocked from the select system call because of which client. So when server starts, the first thing it does is to create a master socket, a socket to detect arrival of new connection request from new client. So this master socket, once it is created by the server, it is used to give birth to rest of the communication file descriptor for the clients. We have already visualized this scenario in the introductory lecture of this module. So C provides a predefined data structure called FD_set, which is a collection of file descriptors. So you can define the variable readFD as set of data type FD_set. So FD_set is actually a data type that is provided by standard C APIs, and it is used as a collection of file descriptors. So remember, file descriptors are simple integers. So FD_set is nothing, but it is a collection of file descriptors which the server is maintaining. So we will discuss more about this FD_set when we will be actually discussing the implementation of TCP server. So guys, let us have a separate discussion on FD_set data structure that is provided by a standard C API. So C provides a data structure called FD_set, which is actually a collection or a set of file descriptors. So the data type is FD_set, and readFDS is actually a variable. So in socket programming in C, we need to use this data structure to maintain our file descriptors. So as we said, that FD_set is actually a collection. So you can visualize this data structure as a collection. So initially, let us assume that this collection is empty. Now, suppose you have a server S and there is a client C1 which sends connection initiation request to the server S, right? So the server S will invoke the accept system call and create a communication file descriptor for client C1. Let this communication file descriptor is 6. So 6 will be added to the readFDS set. Similarly, when the client C2 gets connected with the server S, the server S will create a communication file descriptor for the client C2. Let this communication file descriptor is 7. So 7 will be added to the FD_set or readFDS set. Similarly, whatever be the number of communication file descriptors the server has created in order to service the connected clients, all those communication file descriptors will be added to this FD_set, right? So FD_set is actually a inbuilt data structure provided by C API, which can store and maintain the communication file descriptors in socket programming